And for me, it was a pivot, it was a rearrangement, a change to say, how can I create new rhythms to come alongside guys that are struggling and hurting? And we've got these provisions there for us just to join alongside what Nashville First has developed, what Room in the Inn has developed over the course of time.
Gary Morgan is the pastor of Urban Mission for Nashville First Baptist Church. But here, that's not a title. It is his mission. He's a relatively new volunteer at Room in the Inn in downtown Nashville.
I think it means for us not just, hey, I'm coming out of a castle and engaging in somebody else's life, but I'm living right there in the midst of people from all kind of walks and cultures of life.
Room in the Inn offers emergency services, transitional programs, and long-term solutions to help people rebuild their lives. They do this through programs that emphasize health, education, employment, and housing.
Room in the Inn provides housing and food to some of Nashville's homeless population, and we also have services and spiritual support guidance for people who find themselves homeless.
Ken Curtis is the volunteer coordinator for Nashville First Baptist Church. Each Sunday night from November through March, the volunteers come to the Inn and host the homeless. Some just come and serve them supper. Some stay overnight and help with breakfast.
Usually a Sunday school class, if they can get 4 to 5 members, and we'll always have a team of what we call innkeepers who are always here, they're veterans. They're versed in every part of the ministry. They do the setup. They're here to answer questions. So probably along with one of our innkeeper teams, a Sunday school class of 4 to 5 to 6, plus a couple of overnight hosts is more than enough.
Well, Nashville First Baptist is an example of one of those 60 congregations that throughout the pandemic have found an alternative way to serve. So you are not able to host inside of your building, and so you've actually transplanted your program and you're using our building as though it's your own. That is so much easier said than done. So it is through flexibility, openness, and a willingness to acclimate that we are able to serve 12 guests on Sunday evenings here on our second floor. We could not do that without the help of Nashville First Baptist.
The volunteers provide food and fellowship for those who need it most.
Don't forget the hot sauce.
For guests like David, some finger-licking good chicken isn't just a meal, it's a message of love.
Show me that it's real love in the world. Because it takes a loving heart.
Thank you.
To take out of their time to provide for people in need. And it means a lot.